सदाशिव समारंभां शंकराचार्य मध्यमां अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरां श्रुति स्मृति प्राणानामालयं करुणालयं भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिने व्योमवद् व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं वेदागश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुमहदेवमात्मबुद्धिप्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। नाम्ना यान्ति संसिद्धम् आदिमध्यान्तवर्जितम् आनन्दघनमापूर्णम् आत्मज्योतिरुपास्महे। The next adhikaranam is Natichiradhikaranam, which begins with an introduction by Bhagavan Sadashiv Brahmendra as Itham Purvam Akashadishu Varshanteshu Purvapurva Sadrishyanantaram Uttarottara Sadrishyam Ityuktam. So what was stated and established in the earlier adhikarana? The objection as to Purvapakshi claiming the Jiva taking the form of Akasha literally, then Vayu, Dhuma, Abhra, Megha and Varsha. It was refuted by the Siddhanti by saying there is Sadrisha to Akasha, similarity of form to Akasha, Vayu etc. It is not literal. Jiva does not literally become Akasha or Vayu Ityadi. So there is a similarity. And Uttar Uttar also, later also with Vayu, after Akasha Vayu, after Vayu form, similarity to Akasha, then similarity to Vayu, then similarity to Dhuma etc. This was established. So Ittam Purvam Akashadishu Varshanteshu Purva Purva Sadrishyanantaram. After the similarity to each earlier form mentioned in the Shruti, Uttara Uttara Sadrishyam, then there is similarity to the later form. So Akasha, if it is the earlier form, then Vayu is the later form. After similarity to Akasha, the Jiva gets similarity to Vayu. And this is how the Avarona from the Swargaloka to this Loka is achieved by the Jiva who is Anushayi, meaning who has Shesha Karma. Sanchita karma is still there, it has not been taken away by jnana, therefore sanchita karma is there and prarabdha will lead to another janma here. Iti uktam, this is what was stated and established by refuting the purvapaksha. Tad upajivya anyad vicharyate. So now taking support on what was already established, using that as the basis, the later adhikarana comes up for another vichara. Something else is inquired into. Tad upajivya anyad vicharyate iti upajivya upajivaka bhava sangatya idamah. So this sangati is what? Upajivya upajivaka bhava sangati. This natichiradhikaranam has basis in the earlier adhikarana. So this adhikarana lives on the earlier, that is the meaning of this upajivya upajivaka bhava sangati. Through that, idam aha, Bhagavan Sutrakara gives the first sutra as what? Nati chirena visheshat. So na ati chirena visheshat. What is it saying? It says the purva paksha there. We look at the Purvapaksha as what? Atra Purvapakshe Adhikarinah Sarvatra Tat Sadrishya Parihartam Kartavyasya Prayatnasya Gauravam. Because the Sangati has not explained what exactly is the, only the Sangati as to what is the connection between the earlier and this Adhikarana is mentioned. But the Sangati does not mention as to what is the Purvapaksha. So Purvapaksha is जीवा हु हैज अवरोहणा फ्रॉम दी चंद्रलोका टू दिस लोका, ही हैज सम सिमिलैरिटी. यू हैव सेड देयर इज अ सिमिलैरिटी. ओके, वी से दैट इट इज नॉट द सेम फॉर्म. वी एक्सेप्ट दैट इट इज अ सिमिलैरिटी. नाउ इवन इफ यू एक्सेप्ट द सिमिलैरिटी, देन दिस इष्टादि कर्मकारी मीनिंग दी पुण्यकर्ता वाइल ही गोज फ्रॉम दी चंद्रलोका और कम्स डाउन फ्रॉम दी चंद्रलोका टू भूलोका, ही हैज सादृश्य विथ ईच ऑफ दीज आकाश वायु इत्यादि मेंशन्ड इन दी श्रुति. फाइनली लैंडिंग ऑन दी पृथ्वी थ्रू रेन्स वर्षा. Now, having taken a similarity to Akasha, Vayu, etc., it is difficult for the Jiva to get away from that Sadrushya form. Even if it is not exactly the same form, whatever similarity he has attained with the Akasha or Vayu or Dhuma, it is difficult for the Jiva, after having attained the Akasha सादृश्य शरीर, वायु सादृश्य शरीर, धूम इत्यादि सादृश्य शरीर, इट इज डिफिकल्ट फॉर द जीवा टू लेट गो ऑफ दैट फॉर्म. सो देयर बाय व्हाट विल हैपन इज दिस जीवा विल स्ट्रगल टू लीव दैट फॉर्म एंड गो टू द नेक्स्ट फॉर्म. पूर्व फॉर्म would be difficult to let go of and uttara form cannot be attained. Thereby what will happen? This jiva will be stuck with each form for a long duration of time. This is the perspective of the Purvapaksha. So he says that in each form, akasha, vayu, etc., similarity of form. With each similarity of form to the akasha, vayu, abhra, dhuma, abhra, megha, varsha. This is the sequence. Jiva, since Jiva is going to struggle to come out of the earlier form and get the later form, and then again having attained the later form which he struggles to get off of, and then the movement to the next form is also going to take time. So by the time he lands from the Chandraloka to the Bhuloka, there is going to be lot of time which will elapse. So Chirakala will go away. This is the Purva Paksha. The Siddhanti says, na, ati charena visheshat. It is not so. Why? Because of some vishesha. This vishesha we'll look at into the vritti. I'll just give an idea. Siddhanti says, na, it is not that the jiva will struggle to give up the form. There is only sambandha, meaning there is some association only, but he is not identifying with the similarity of form. So with Akasha Sadrushya form, he has no identification. It is just he is taking that as a some association to get to the next form, and then the next form and the next form, till he lands on the Bhumi as Varsha. There is no reason to have identification with the Akasha Vayu Ityadi ending with Varsha. There is no identification there. It is not the traveler jivas, the one who has avarona, that jivas mukhyat sambandha. There is no mukhya sambandha there. There is gauna sambandha, meaning it is only for travel purposes of travel. He is connecting with such kind of a form. It is a vehicle rather. It is like a vehicle. So imagine this. Let's say somebody, this Chaitra, is traveling by his car, his own car. He has spent a lot of money, he has accumulated money, and he has taken a car. And while driving, he loves his car. Somebody passes by and scratches the car. What is this guy going to say? Oh, that guy hit me. The other guy who just passed by in his vehicle scratched this fellow's vehicle. But what is the identification with the car as? Oh, he hit me. I was just going and following my rules in my own lane, but the other chap hit me. He has not hit you at all. In fact, the other guy's car has hit your car, scratched your car. It has nothing to do with you. But what is the claim by Chaitra? oh, hate me. But imagine the person who is traveling in the car along with him, he has no such claim over the car. What will he say? He'll say the other chap hit this fellow's car. Or he'll say he hit Chaitra. So Maitra, who is just using it as a vehicle to travel, he has no ownership claim on the car, will say what? He'll say that the other chap hit Chaitra or hit Chaitra's car. He'll not say he hit me. So this kind of a sambandha as a traveler is there, but there is no mukhya sambandha, there is no identification of the jiva with the traveler jiva. One who has avarodha from the Chandraloka to Bhuloka, he has no sambandha of mukhya tadatmya with the akasha vayu ityadi. Whoever it is that we say vayu devata etc., they may have tat sambandha as tadatmya, they may play the role with the akasha, maintain the akasha as the sharira, vayu as the sharira. We have these in shastra, we see purana ityadi, we see vayu devata, Varuna Devata, etc. So they do what they do with this Varsha Ityadi. But then this traveler jiva or any multiple may also be there, they do not have any connection with it. Or another example would be right, like you know, you have in your Sharira there are a lot of other kinds of creamies, etc. They are also, you know, living beings. We don't see them, so we don't have an issue. But if you go to a doctor, we'll say, you know something. You know, a COVID example was very famous. The virus. Virus is living. So that living virus, in multiples, they are within. We cannot see them. But then, any of these, so viral fever also, you'll say, you know, something is there. Antibiotics are given to deal with such viruses. They are all living within. But do they have the tadatme sambandha with the sharira the way I have as a jiva? They don't. They have tadatma sambandha with their own sukshma, whatever sharira is there. So many shariris are within this whole sharira where I, the mukhya jiva, has sambandha. Others are just traveling and they are making use of it as a residence, but they have nothing to do with the entire sharira being claimed as it is my sharira. Similarly, these traveler jivas have no association with akashadi sharira or similarity. Akashadi sadrishya shariras also, this with sadrishyam also, they don't have any mukhya association as tadatmya sambandha. So they won't have difficulty to leave the rupa, such kind of a rupa. Thereby what will happen? The travel will be fast. It will not be that they are stuck and they are trying to give up the association and then move to the next form. Therefore, na aticharena. Aticharena, jiva will have travel. Aticharena meaning with a little, alpam alpam kalam eva akashadi varshantahi sadrushena avasthaya. That is the meaning of na aticharena. Why Vishesha? What is this Vishesha? We'll see more in the Vritti, but I'll just give an overview as to what this is. After having fallen onto the ground, this I have mentioned earlier in the earlier Patha, the final goal is to take Janma in a womb, etc. But then we'll primarily say in a human being's womb. Now that being the case, when as Varsha the Jiva has fallen onto the Bhuloka, then there itself there is a struggle to be growing as Vrihi and being eaten not by an animal, not by a cow, goat, etc., herbivorous animals, not by a child or an elderly, not by a girl or a woman, not by an old man, but a young man who is trying to beget a child. So look at the difficulty. There he is going to struggle. When the jiva has a struggle in the sense, the jiva will have very less probability in comparison to so many eaters of vrihi, of the crop, in which he has taken this form and is waiting to be consumed so that he goes from the Purusha to the Stri as the fifth Ahuti and then takes birth after the gestation period. So there is a long wait. But for coming down from Chandraloka to Bhuloka, there is no wait. This is the background to the Visheshat Shabda there. So let's move on and see the Vritti. It will be clearer. Atra Purvapakshe Adhikarinaha Sarvatra Tat Sadrishya Pariharartam Kartavyasya Prayatnasya Gauravam. Lot of prayatna has to be done by Jiva. Who is your Adhikari? The Adhikari for Janma into Bhuloka. So the Purvapakshi says Sarvatra Tat Sadrishya Pariharartam. Whatever form has been taken, similarity to Akasha, similarity to Vayu, etc. forms are being taken, are to be taken by this Jiva everywhere. All these which are mentioned, stages which are mentioned by the Shruti, there Sarvatra, to give up Sadrushya, Kartavyasya Prayatnasya Gauravam. Whatever effort the Jiva has to take, that is a lot. It's a lot of effort. Siddhante Tadartham Kartavya Prayatnasya Kvachit Laghavam Kvachit Gauravam Iti Phalabheda. In Siddhanta, what is it? Sometimes there is effort needed, sometimes there is no effort. Sometimes there is a small waiting period, sometimes there is no waiting period, sometimes there is a long waiting period. So it all depends on what kind of an association with which kind of a sadrushya. So it is not that there is a lot of effort needed. There may be some effort needed at some places. Some places it is very easy. So this is the difference between Siddhanti and Purvapaksha. Purvapakshi's perspectives. Tatra kim jivaha chirakalam eva sadrushyena avasthaya apara sadrushyam gachati uta alpam alpam iti vishaye. Whether the jiva has to wait with each sadrushya form, similar form, chirakalam eva sadrushyena avasthaya apara sadrushyam gachati or alpam alpam iti vishaye. Whether he has to wait for a long time with each form or has to wait for a little time. Iti vishaye, when there is such a doubt raised, then niyamaka bhavat aniyamaha iti purvapaksha. Purvapaksha says there is no such niyama, how much time, etc. As long as it takes to get away with prayatna, get away with the sadrushya identification, the jiva has to wait. How much time he has to wait, we cannot say. Why? Because there is no niyama. There is no niyama as to this akasha sadrushya, what is the struggle with vayu sadrushya form, what is the struggle, we do not know. So whatever kind of a jiva has, whichever kind of a struggle to give up the identification with akasha sadrushya, vayu sadrushya form, based on that, such a length of time would be needed. You cannot say that this much time will be needed. It can be any period of time. Siddhantastu. Siddhanti says it is not so. Jevaha nati chirena alpam alpam kalam eva akashadi varshantaihi sadrushena avasthaya varshadhara dvara prithvim pravishati. So nati chirena meaning alpam alpam. Alpam alpam is the meaning of nati chirena. Waiting very little time, alpam alpam kalam eva, waiting only very little time to, because there is not much effort needed, little effort may be needed, but then the jiva does not stay connected with the sadrushya form of akasha for a long time, it connects with a very less time, then with the vayu also very less time, similarly with dhuma ityadi, finally comes down as varsha, where also he can easily give up the association. So alpam alpam kalam eva akashadi varshantahi sadrushyena avasthaya. Being present in forms similar to akasha, vayu ityadi ending with rain, finally what? Varshadhara dvara prithvim pravishati. He enters the bhuloka through the rains. Kutaha, how so? Why should it be so? Ask the Purvapakshi. To that the Siddhanti answers, व्रीहादि भावापत्यनंतरम अतो वै खलु दुर्निष्प्रपतरम इति विशेषा. सो विशेषा इज द मूला हियर. सो व्हाट इज द विशेषा देयर? सिद्धांति सेज आफ्टर हैविंग फॉलन ऑन द भूमि व्रीहादि भाव आपत्य अनंतरम आफ्टर हैविंग टेकन द फॉर्म विच इज ऑफ द राइस एटसेट्रा दिस ग्रेन्स राइस व्हीट व्हाट एवर इट इज. सो हैविंग बिकम दोज having taken such kind of an association, not again as mukhya, there also the those who have been given the karma phala as being getting the janma of vrihi ityadi crops. So in abundance vrihi ityadi rice, wheat, barley, etc. are growing. So those mukhya jivas who are associated with such crop, individual ankura of such crops, all those jivas are getting that as their karma phala. However, this jiva who is traveling and has the end goal as being born as a human being in a womb or something else, but mostly that, as we saw in the last part, that jiva has no mukhya association with vrihi adi. However, he cannot shift from that form to another form unless being consumed by the purusha, consumed by anyone. But only being consumed by a young male who can produce an offspring and wants to produce an offspring, there alone his journey will fructify into janma, and true with anyone who is associated with the crops also. Now that being the case, it is very difficult. Durnish prapataram, it is difficult. Khalu, why indeed it is difficult. Ataha, later, after that, ataha, after what? Vrihyadi bhavapatyanantaram. Ataha, therefore, or ataha smat. After also you can take the vrihadi bhavapatya anantaram. After having attained the rice etc. kind of a form. Not before. Before he has gone from akasha vayu ityadi till varsha. And now after having taken vrihadi, then there is difficulty. Ataha ato vai khalu durnish prapataram says the chandogya shruti. What does that mean? That means that only after attaining the status of vrihi ityadi, there is further difficulty in getting a womb to be born. As it can be eaten by any animal, or a child, or an old man, or a woman. So, it shows that there is ease before it. This is the visheshat. Vishesha of difficulty is shown only later, after taking vrihadi form. Therefore, before taking vrihadi form, meaning ending with varsha, starting with akasha, those forms, in those forms there is no difficulty. So that is also vishesha. You have to differentiate between the difficulty which has been mentioned by the shruti after taking vrihi adi janma, vrihi adi bhava, and before that you have to separate out from akasha to varsha. So with that separation, what do you know? You know that ato vai khalu durnishprapataram is after attaining the vrihyadi form. Till he lands in the womb, there is difficulty. He has to try again and again being, eaten by something. Otherwise, again, same journey will continue. Iti visheshat tatav purvam sunishprapatataratvam pratiyate. Therefore, before attaining the vrihadi form, there is ease. So there is a dur and su. So dur is used in chandogya, and but it is after the vrihadi. It is used for after vrihadi form. Therefore, since dur is there, dur difficulty. Dur shows what? Dukhena. So you can reverse that for the stages before vrihadi form, meaning akashadi vriyanta. Akashadi Varshanta. In Akashadi Varshanta Sadrushya forms, you can add a Sushtu or Sukhena. There is no difficulty. Therefore, Nati Charena Gachyati Jivaha. So सो दैट इज द विशेषादेर तत्र प्रतीयते दिस इज व्हाट वी कैन सी दिस इज व्हाट इट अपीयर्स टू बी देयरफॉर दिस इज द रीजनिंग दैट सिद्धांती सेज आई हैव यूज्ड टू लैंड ऑन द मीनिंग ऑफ अल्प अल्प स्थिति इन ईच ऑफ द सादृश्य फॉर्म्स तत्र व्रीहि आकाशादो जीवस्य प्रतीयमाने सुखदुःखे चिरकाल अवस्थान अल्प काल अवस्थाने भवतः न मुख्ये सो नाउ दिस दुर एंड सु विच हैज बीन यूज विच आर दी प्रादि और दी उपसर्ग यूज देयर दे स्टैंड फॉर सुख एंड दुख And sukha dukha are not in literal sense. They are adverbial. So when you say dukhena bhavati, dukhena gacchati, then what it means, dukhena gacchati qualifies the verb and thereby it's an adverb. So what will it mean is that with difficulty. It will not mean dukha as in sorrow. It means with difficulty. There is no papa, prapa bhoga. Dukha is a result of papa. But this jiva who is traveling, who while traveling, having landed on vrihyadi also, so vrihyadi bhava apatti anantaram, after attaining the form of vrihyadi bhava, waiting there is for a long period and but the being eaten etc., being walked over, all this will not cause dukkha to this traveler jiva. To the jiva who is associated in the mukhya bhava, there is pain. So there is sorrow. But one who is traveling will not have pain. Because he has no mukhya association. He is just using the crop's body as a vehicle to travel. Therefore, this dur there which lands in dukkha, that does not have the main meaning of sorrow for this traveler jiva. What does it have? It has the meaning of alpakala. Chirakala. So sukha dukkhe sukha. Sukha also does not mean there is sukha. Wherein sunish prapataratvam earlier, meaning the earlier part of the journey from akasha to varshanta, beginning with akasha sadrushya form, ending with varsha sadrushya form, there is sukha, meaning there is no sukha as in happiness. It is not in literal sense. Sukhena gacchati ityartha jiva. So jiva travels easily. Meaning alpakalena gacchati, consumes only little time, but later he may consume a lot of time, he has to wait, that is the dukkha there, but there is no sorrow. So it is not in the mukhya meaning, na mukhye, but what is the meaning? He says tatra vrihi akashadu. So in beginning with vrihi, there is dukkha, meaning there is difficulty, not sorrow, difficulty, and what is the difficulty? Chirakala avasthanam. Staying for a long time. And akashadav jivasya pratimane dukkha. What is that dukkha? Sukha dukkhe pratiyamane sukha dukkhe is dvivachana. So we'll split it. Vrihi, with vrihi the association, jiva's association gives, is through sukha. The journey is through sukha means it is an easy journey. Meaning what? Alpakala avasthana. Staying for a little time. Being associated with a similarity to akashadi form. But with vrihyadi, I may have reversed it, I said akashadi. So with akashadi, there is a sukhena gamana. The journey is easy from akasha to ending with vayu for the jiva. And what is the meaning there? Sukha meaning, that is alpakala avasthana. And with vrihyadi, meaning beginning with vrihi, after the varsha form, enters into vrihyadi form, there, what will happen? Vrihyadi has dukkha. And what is that dukkha? It is not sorrow. Dukkhena gamana ityartha, meaning gamanam, meaning there is a movement with difficulty. And what is that meaning? Chirakala avasthana. That itself is dukkha. Na mukhe. Na mukhe meaning na mukhe pratyamane sukha dukkhe. There is no happiness in the literal sense or sorrow in the literal sense for this traveler jiva. For the associated jiva with tadatmya sambandha, which is his karma phala as becoming vrihi atyadi, definitely there is sukha dukkha. You see in chandogya, upari hanyet, so all that is, there is a section where it is said that the vruksha will feel pain, and when it is watered, when it is basically cut with an axe or attacked with an axe, hit with an axe, then there is dukkha for the vriksha, being the jiva who is associated as vriksha with tadatmya sambandha. And when given water, the vriksha is happy. So there is mukhya sukha and dukkha, but here there is no mukhya sukha and dukkha for the traveler jiva. It only means chirakala avasthana or alpakala avasthana, respectively for sukha and dukkha, which is the meaning of su and dur. Suffix is there. So tatra vihi akashadu jivasya pratyamane sukha dukhe na mukhe. But what are those chirakala avasthana alpakala avasthane bhavataha. So they are only staying for a long duration or short duration, respectively for vrihyadi long duration and for akashadi varshanta less duration. This is the dukkha and sukha respectively. Tadanim vina stula shariram linga sharira matrena sukha dukkha upabhoga sambhavat. Why do you say so? Why can't the dur and su suffixes being the mukhya meaning of dukkha and sukha, ask the Purvapakshi. To that the Siddhanti answers, in those stages, tadanim vina stula sharira, there is no stula sharira, there is only sukshma sharira. The travelling jiva has no stula sharira at all. And without the stula sharira, which is the adhikarana, where the sukshma sharira can generate sukha and dukkha, meaning can have vritti of sukha and dukkha, that possibility itself is not there because there is no stula sharira at all. When in the akashadi varshanta and then vrihyadi also, so tadanim vina stula shariram linga sharira matrena sukha dukkha upabhoga asambhavat. Linga sharira means sukshma sharira. With the sukshma sharira there is an association, otherwise there cannot be individual jiva. Jiva is individualized only with the sharira traya sambandha. So without the sukshma sharira there cannot be an individuality at all. So stula shariram vina, without the stula sharira association, then what happens? Linga sharira matrena, the jiva is traveling only with an association with the sukshma sharira, and through that there is no possibility, asambhava, due to impossibility of upabhoga of sukha and dukkha. Sukha dukkha yoho upabhogasya asambhava tadanim, during that journey, because only sukshma sharira association is there and this traveler cannot have sukha dukkha bhoga. So there is no sukha dukkha at all. There is no happiness and sorrow in the literal sense in the journey, starting with the fall from Swargaloka, because after Swargaloka, Sukha has been exhausted. This fellow who is going to take Janma now and Swargavasa is over, then he feels Dukkha there because his Sharira is vanishing. And we saw that Sharira vanishing is compared to Agni burning, and then this Sharira, as though it burns and vaporizes into form similar to Akasha, Vayu, Ityadi, finally comes as Varsha. So there is no Sukha Dukkha during the journey at all. There is only a weight. There is a kala, and this, since there is no sukha dukkha, he cannot even experience the weight. So it is like being in a sushupti avastha. You do not know whether you slept for 1 hour or for 2 days. If you are really tired from a torturous journey or something, one may sleep straight through a day or two, wouldn't know. So like as if in a coma. Just because the calendar and the time or others tell you that this is the date, you know, okay, so many days have passed or only an hour has passed. Without that, we have absolutely no way to know whether we slept for 2 minutes or 1 hour or, whatever may the case be in the pralayavastha, whether it is 1 year or multiple kalpas or multiple yugas also ending with a kalpa. So that is the case of this jiva who has gone to sleep. Immediately after mrityu, the jiva goes to sleep and wakes up in some other loka. So the sukshma sharira association, there is no possibility of sukha dukkha bhoga. Only in swarga loka, pitra loka, ityadi, there is some association with some kind of a sharira whereby sukha dukkha bhoga is possible, mostly sukha. Or if tarpana ityadi is not offered, then in pitra loka the pitras will feel dukkha also. अतः व्रीहादि प्रवेशात पूर्वम बिफोर एंटरिंग इनटू क्रॉप्स काइंड ऑफ फॉर्म्स एज राइस एटसेट्रा पूर्वम अल्पम अल्पम एव कालम तत्सादृश्येन अवस्थानम इति सिद्धम. देयरफॉर बिफोर बिकमिंग अ क्रॉप ऑफ राइस एटसेट्रा टिल द जीवा डज नॉट गेट डाउन ऑन द भूलोक एज रेन्स द ट्रैवल फ्रॉम आकाश सादृश्य फॉर्म टिल देन व्हाट देयर इज अल्प अल्प एव काल अवस्था अल्प अल्प काल अवस्था ओनली बिफोर एंटरिंग द व्रीहादि राइस एटसेट्रा. सो तत्सादृश्येन अवस्थानम अल्पम अल्पम कालम एव इति सिद्धम. दिस इज एस्टैब्लिश देयर इज ओनली शॉर्ट स्टे एंड देयरफॉर द जर्नी फ्रॉम स्वर्गलोक टू भूलोक विल नॉट टेक अ लॉन्ग टाइम. ओनली आफ्टर बिकमिंग राइस एटसेट्रा देयर मे बी अ लॉन्ग टाइम वेट फॉर बीइंग ईटन बाय द राइट जीवा फॉर्म एंड टेकिंग जन्म इन अ पर्टिकुलर शरीर. जे अधिकरण इज ओवर. शब्दस्य चिरकाल अवस्थान लक्षकत्वे अपि प्रकृते व्रीह्यादि भावेन जायन्ते इति जीवजन्म श्रुतेः मुख्यत्व संभवा इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्या इदमाह. द पूर्वपक्षी इज गिविंग अ काउंटर एग्जांपल. देयर इज अ काउंटर एग्जांपल एज टू व्हाट शब्दस्य चिरकाल अवस्थान लक्षकत्वेपि. यू हैव यूज लक्षण मुख्य मुख्यार्थ परित्यागेन लक्षण. यू हैव गिवन अप द मुख्यार्थ ऑफ सुख एंड दुख एज हैप्पीनेस एंड सोरो एंड यू हैव टेकन द लक्षण एज टू एडवर्बियल लॉन्गर वेट और अ शॉर्टर वेट. दैट इज पॉसिबल सेज द पूर्वपक्षी. शब्दस्य चिरकाल अवस्थान लक्षकत्वे अपि even then what prakrute in a context that he is bringing up as an extra adhikarana as anyadishthati anyadishthita adhikaranam anyadishthita adhikaranam there prakruta in that adhikarana the context that is being vrihadi bhavina. So the in the context of the earlier adhikarana where vrihadi bhava was talked about vrihadi bhavena jayante thereby what happens it has been jay vrihadi bhavena jayante after having come down to bhuloka as what as varsha then fallen onto the bhumi on a wet ground then the jiva takes to the crop which is growing there and associates there. Now what does the shruti say? Shruti says vrihadi bhavena jayante. So far you have said sadrishya takes a similar form of akasha ending with varsha, but now vrihadi bhavena jayante, in that context this jiva is going to be born as the rice or some other crop. So if that is the janma as per the jiva janma shruti, it is a jiva janma shruti now because jayante word is used there. Jani pradurbhave jayante, the jivas are born in the form of vrihi ityadi, thereby जीव जन्म श्रुते है. ड्यू टू दैट जीव जन्म श्रुति जायन्ते इज अ श्रुति एंड इट इज द फॉर्म ऑफ जनि प्रादुर्भावे धातु. सो जन्म इज टू बी टेकन एज मुख्य. सो जीव जन्म श्रुते है. ड्यू टू दैट जीव जन्म श्रुति जायन्ते इति मुख्यत्व संभव मुख्यत्व संभवे और मुख्यत्व संभव. इट इज डेफिनेटली मुख्यत्व इज पॉसिबल. मुख्यत्व इज पॉसिबल इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत्या इदमाह. मुख्यत्व संभव. देयर इज पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ मुख्यत्व. व्हाट मुख्यत्व? मुख्यत्व ऑफ दिस जन्म. व्रीहादि जन्म इज मुख्य जन्म फॉर दिस जीवा नॉट गौण. ही इज नॉट अ ट्रैवलर हु इज एसोसिएटेड बट ही इज टेकिंग जन्म एज व्रीहादि इति प्रत्युदाहरण संगत. बाय दिस काउंटर एग्जाम्पल दी नेक्स्ट अधिकरण हैज संबंध एंड इट कम्स अप एज व्हाट विद दी फर्स्ट सूत्र बाय भगवान सूत्रकार. अन्याधिष्ठितायेषु पूर्ववद अभिलापात अन्याधिष्ठितेषु पूर्ववद अभिलापात. सो दी सिद्धांति सेज अन्याधिष्ठितेषु अन्याधिष्ठितेषु पूर्ववत अभिलापात. थ्री पदस आर देयर. व्हाट डज ही से? अन्याधिष्ठितेषु. कस्मात् अन्याधिष्ठितेषु? जीवाद अन्य अधिष्ठितेषु. सो जीवाद अन्य अधिष्ठितेषु पूर्ववत, पूर्ववत मीन्स व्हाट, वायु सदृशवत और आकाश आदि सदृशवत, सिमिलर टू दी अर्लियर स्टेट्स और व्हाट इज दैट, प्रवेशस्य अभिलापात, दी प्रवेश हियर वेर इन दी व्रीहादि फॉर्म्स इन दी क्रॉप एटसेट्रा द एसोसिएशन नीड नॉट बी मुख्य, इट कैन बी पूर्ववत, इट इज, इट कैन बी लाइक द एसोसिएशन दैट वॉज देयर अर्लियर मीनिंग आकाशादि वर्षांत, इन आकाशादि वर्षांत पूर्ववत अभिलापात, प्रवेश से अभिलापात, बिकॉज प्रवेश हैज बीन स्टेटेड इन दैट मैनर लाइक अर्लियर, दैट लाइक अर्लियर मीन्स वॉट, गौण, इट कैनॉट बी मुख्य, जस्ट लाइक अर्लियर सादृश्य एसोसिएशन वॉज देर, देर वॉज नो नो मुख्य एसोसिएशन, सिमिलरली हियर पूर्ववत अभिलापात जीव विच देर मुख्य जीवा हु इज देर एसोसिएटेड विथ व्रीहादि, देर ऑल्सो दी जीवाद अन्याधिष्ठितेषु पूर्ववत अभिलापा, देर इज प्रवेश इज पूर्ववत, सो दी मुख्य जीवा इज गोइंग टू बी प्रेजेंट इन दी अधिष्ठान ऑफ दी व्रीहादि शरीर, बट मुख्य जीवात अन्य इज दिस ट्रैवलर जीवा, दैट फेलो विल नॉट हैव मुख्य एसोसिएशन, दैट इज दी सूत्रार्थ, वी लुक एट मोर इन दी वृत्ति, अत्र पूर्वपक्षे व्रीहादिजन्मनः मुख्यत्वे अनुशयिनां तत्परिहाराय अधिकरणादिकं प्रयतितव्यं, सिद्धान्ते तदीय संसर्गमात्रं निराकर्तुं न अधिकं प्रयतितव्यं इति फलभेदः. A similar objection to earlier adhikaranas where the journey is said to be from akasha to varsha, starting with Swargaloka, ending with Bhuloka, this jiva has to take lot of effort to disassociate from the similar forms to Akasha to similar forms to Varsha, ending there. So similar objection is raised by Purvapakshe, Atra Purvapakshe, in Purvapaksha, Vrihadi Janmanaha Mukhyatve, Mukhyatve Sati, when Vrihadi Janma Jiva, the Vrihadi Janma of the Jiva is what? It is Mukhya. It is main janma. If that is the case, then what has happened? Anushayina, the jivas who are having shesha karma, for them to dissociate from the vrihadi janma, vrihadi sharira, tat pariharaya, adhikarina, अधिकं प्रयतितव्यम्, बाय दिस अधिकारी, विच अधिकारी, द ट्रैवलर अधिकारी हु हैज टेकन व्रीहादि जन्म आफ्टर फॉलिंग ऑन टू द भूमि थ्रू वर्षा, एंड इन प्लूरल अनुशयिनां, बाय देम तत्परि, सो दिस अनुशयिनां कैन गो विद द अर्लियर, अत्र पूर्व, बिकॉज अदरवाइज अन्वय विल नॉट बी प्रॉपर, अत्र पूर्वपक्षे व्रीहादि जन्मनः मुख्यत्वे अनुशयिनां, सो तत्परिहाराय अधिकारिणा अधिकम प्रयतितव्यम, व्हाट शुड ही डू, जस्ट गिव मी वन मोमेंट टू थिंक ओवर देयर, अधिकारिणा नो इट, आई थिंक द या दैट्स हाउ द अन्वय वुड बी, just get, let me check the print whether adhika here with anushayinam is there or what is the word there, just give me one moment, I'm looking at the wrong sutra, sorry, anyadishtateshu anushayinam, yeah it's the same word, so anushayinam, it's a plural, this plural is a little off-putting, it has to go with the earlier, otherwise does not seem to be right there. What other possibility is there? because here there is a adhikarina, that adhikarina is in singular, so that is the difficulty there. I'm having trouble with anvaya there. Let me check that second word, adhikarina. It is right, tatparihara adhikarina adhikam prayajitavyam. So anyway, let's try to make sense out of this by splitting the earlier part into plural into the earlier connection and then singular with the later part. So atra purvapakshe vrihadi janmanah mukhyatve anushayinam. So for anushay is vrihadi janma, when it is taken as mukhya, that is how we will do an anvaya. Then tatparihara, to do parihara, what should one do? Tatparihara adhikarina adhikam prayatitavyam. By the adhikari, singular, now he has used singular, by an adhikari, by tritiya ekvachana, adhikam prayatitavyam. He has to, by him, more effort has to be taken. Which is similar to the objection that we saw earlier. Here the issue is only about the ekavachana and bahuvachana. Earlier bahuvachana, now then ekavachana. Siddhanta, in Siddhanta what is it? The case, tadiya samsarga matram. There is only an association. Tadiya samsarga matram nirakartum. Tatra dukkha bhogaha nasti. Sukha bhoga api nasti. Samsarga matram asti. So what is the case of this traveler jiva? This traveler jiva is associated with the vrihadi sharira. Not as this is my sharira, but I am using it as a means to travel. That's all. As we saw in other examples, Laukika examples. So, nirakartam, to take away such association, what should he do? He should just say, goodbye, I am going. That's all. It is not that he is staying with his relatives and friends and, you know, chit-chatting. It is not that there is any dukkha to leave that crop also, because he knows he is going to take a better janma. So, tadiya samsarga matram nirakartam, if you have to personify that, na adhikam prayatitavyam, there is no effort, much effort needed, iti phala bheda. Okay, I have already overshot the time, I have another part coming up, so we will stop here and look at the meaning. Currently, the meaning is, further vritti, the meaning is that this jiva who is travelling does not have to struggle, just like earlier, Purva, did he have to travel to dissociate with Akasha Vayu? No. So, here also it is not mukhya janma. Mukhya janma is for other jivas. They have to struggle as long as prarabdha is there. They have to struggle with the dukkha, and there may be some sukha when they are watered and taken care of, all that. But when they are cut and then they are beaten, etc., there is dukkha for the jiva who is surviving there, who has not died. That kind of a jiva associated with the crop, sharira, they may have to struggle. They will have to struggle as long as prarabdha is ticking. But this fellow who is traveling, that jiva does not have to struggle. So, na adhikam prayajita kutaha nirakartum. Tadiya samsarga matram is hetu there. Hetu garbha visheshana tadiya samsarga matram nirakartum. To take away only samsarga. Samsarga is sanyoga, sambandha. He just has some kind of a sambandha as a vehicle. What is the sambandha between the vehicle and the traveler? That is the only sambandha there. He has absolutely no tadatmya there. And therefore, he has no mukhya jiva bhava there. He has no struggle there to dissociate himself from the vehicle kind of a crop. Further, we will see in the next part. Amnayantek samsiddham adhi madhyanta varjitam ananda ghanam apurnam atma jyoti rupasmahe. Namaste dhanyavadha. In the second pada, we'll have more Vedanta, so it will have an easier flow than this kind of a struggle where karma is difficult, journey is difficult, upasanas and karma and the other siddhantis, other darshanikas also, so far in three chapters and the first pada, two chapters and first pada of the three chapters, there is some struggle for us to look at various viewpoints. But in second pada onwards, there is some kind of a relief there. Because more Vedanta proper would step in. So we'll see. This we are almost at the end of this pada. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Yeah, sure, namaste. Dhanyavada.